Hi friends, welcome to Setu's Biology. Today our topic is about immunity. First of all, I would like to tell you that the immunity, the study of our immune system is known as the immunology. Immunology. Actually, what is meant by immunity means it is a type of resistance which is exhibited by in our body against any foreign antigen. Means if any foreign antigen is entered into our body. In example, I will tell you that. Just imagine that this is our body. When the any foreign antigen is entered into our body through any route, then in our body our immune system is going to fight against this antigen. That is known as immunity. That is a resistance which is going to exhibit against foreign antigen is known as immunity. This type of resistance is playing a major role for the prevention of any infectious disease. Means if we are suffering for any cold or cough or headache, any infectious disease if we are suffering, means this resistance is going to play a major role for preventing that infectious disease in our body. Let's see what are the different types of immunity in our body. Actually, the immunity is splitted into two types based on the type of immunity in our body. Let's see what are those: innate immunity and the acquired immunity. Innate immunity is also known as the native immunity, and the acquired immunity is also known as the adaptive immunity. In the name itself, we came to know that innate and the native immunity. Native place means the immunity is present in our body through the birth onwards only. Means the person is possessing this type of immunity from the birth only. That is known as the innate or the native immunity. This type of immunity is acting fighting against the first line of defense for the any infectious disease. Let's go to the acquired immunity and the adaptive. Acquired means taking, means during our lifetime, what type of food we are taking, in which lifestyle we are living, based on the environmental condition, based on the all type of living conditions where we are living, in that way this type of acquired immunity is acquires in our lifetime. This is known as the acquired immunity. This acquired immunity is acting as a second line of defense in any infectious disease. Let's see with the individual one. Let's see with the innate immunity. Innate immunity is again classified into the three types. There are species immunity, racial immunity, and the individual immunity. Means species immunity means there are different species. Means humans come under one species, fishes come under one species, chickens come under one species, like that. Different species are present here. This immunity is fighting against the different species. Means the for example, Bacillus anthracis. Anthrax is a disease which mainly affects the human beings, but it is not going to affect the chickens. This is a one major example for the species immunity. Means the chickens are more resistant for this disease, but the humans are susceptible for this. That's the main role played here. Let's go to the racial immunity. Means in one species they contain different races. Means in human beings only American Negroes are there and the white race people are there. Like that, the races may differentiate. For example, tuberculosis is the disease. American Negroes are more susceptible to this disease. Means they are more attacked with this disease, but the white race people are more resistant to this disease. Means this disease may not occur the white race people. This is a major difference between the racial immunity. Let's go to the individual immunity. Means it is based on the individual immunity. Means if two persons are there, this person is attacked with the fevers or something else, but he is healthy because of their lifetime, because of their food habits, because of their individual life process. Based on the individual immunity may build up. This is three different types of the innate immunity. Let's go to the acquired immunity. Acquired immunity is again classified into two types. There are the active immunity and the passive immunity. Active immunity means the immunity which is going to build up in our body, host only building the immunity in his body. Passive immunity means through the from the artificial source of means we are injecting the artificial immunity into the human body. That is known as the passive immunity. Let's see. Active immunity is again split into two types, natural and the artificial. Means through any clinical and the subclinical infections. Means if any antigen is entered into our body, then our immune system is activated and producing the antibodies against it. That is the natural active immunity. Let's next to the artificial immunity. Artificial active immunity means we are inducing the vaccination here. Means we are inducing the vaccines. Means if for example, I already said that Bacillus anthracis is the one of the bacteria which is going to cause the anthrax disease. We are preparing the vaccines from the Bacillus anthrax. Means we are taking the antigen. We are killing the antigens. We are preparing the vaccine. That vaccine is induced into the host, means any human body, but it is not going to cause any infection, but it is acting as an antigen. If our body recognizes that the antigen is entered into our body, then our body is going to produce the antibodies, means the immunity is building up even in our body. That is a way of acting as a artificial active immunity. These are the active natural immunity and the active artificial immunity. Means in our body only through the different routes the immunity is boosting up through the any infection or the vaccination. Let's go to the passive immunity. Passive immunity, I already said that artificially we are injecting the antibodies into our body. Means the immunity is boosting up from the artificial mode, from the outside. That is known as a passive immunity. Let's go to, these are also split into two types, natural and the artificial. Natural means from the transplacent, from the mother to child through the placental route, the immunity is transferred from the mother to the baby through the maternal IgG antibodies, through feeding. During feeding, the mother antibody, the mother IgG antibodies are transferred into the baby. In that way, the natural passive immunity may transfer to the baby. Let's go to the artificial immunity through anti-serum injections. If we are, for example, if we are suffering with any injection, we are going to treat that. Means we are going to inject the anti-serum, means antibodies against that infection through the injection form. In that way, the anti-serum, means the antibodies which are entered into our body, those are going to fight against the antigen and those are going to kill that antigen. In this way, the passive artificial immunity is going to work. These are the different types of immunity. What is going, what is making a defensive action against any antigen which is entered into our body. In the next video, I'm going to give the detailed information about the what are antigens and also the what are antibodies. The minimum basic points, we can't understand the any bacterial disease, any bacterial infection, this pathogenesis or anything. That's why I'm going to give the basic detail and basic information first. I think you like this video. If you like this video, please do subscribe and share. Thank you.